airport.
Okay.
The dinner's after the deal.
Oh, yeah.
There's three things. We got a TV show, a record signing, and then Ben the dinner.
Oh, I didn't know what
that's the Eiffel Tower right there. Wow. See that thing?
Oh, boy. I got to eat.
I'm so hungry.
Plenty of candy.
Je femme. Is that I'm hungry?
I think playing new songs in front of an audience that hasn't had a chance to hear them is really the ultimate test of how good the songs are and how good the dynamics and the energy that you put into the songs come across. And it's a great challenge, and I really enjoy the challenge of trying to put new songs across before an album comes out, because it really gives you a sense of the emotional connection that you can penetrate without people coming with a conscious thought of what it's supposed to sound like and what it's supposed to be.
Chaque emplacement du miroir est décidé de là où on allait bouger. Donc, vous pouvez vous imaginer que ça représente effectivement du travail.
There better be earplugs on stage.
On peut se dire, you on stage, ok? Yeah, you need to see the guy for the cue, same guy, same cue.
Talked about Jimmy rejoining the band, I'd say probably a couple months before we actually played together. So there was this kind of anticipatory period. So when we finally did actually kind of get in a room, and it was, we both kind of had our heads down, like, it was kind of nervous, you know, because it's like, you don't know. You don't know whether that same thing's going to be there. And within 1 minute, it was like he'd never left and things were completely the same.
Making the new record, the first couple of days of rehearsal, obviously for me was, you know, excitement, apprehension, anticipation, but most of all, just the reacquainting of the love in the band and the energy in the band, which I think really comes across on the record.
Radio, play my favorite song. Radio.
The main goal of the record that we talked about with Flood when we first started was to make a really exciting record. And by exciting, I don't mean rock and roll exciting. I mean viscerally exciting, like I've never heard this before, or this is a really exciting performance. So everything was always about excitement, excitement. So it wasn't even a musical direction or a sonic direction that we began with. As the record evolved, the record seemed to kind of fall into different categories. One being kind of very ultra psychedelic, one being extremely heavy, and then this kind of almost big atmospheric sound. But that was nothing by design. We never sat down and discussed that specifically. It just kind of seemed to happen out of the idea of making things exciting. Because, you know, you can snap your fingers and you can go back to doing what you used to do, but to us it's not exciting anymore. the songs were pretty open-ended, and I felt like I could pretty much play anything or do anything I wanted. And I think the way Flood tried to direct or encourage me was just in certain aspects of my playing, just atmospheric stuff, melodic stuff, non-cliched rock guitar things, things that don't sound like a guitar.
What makes the record unique, in a sense, for a band like us is the experiences that we went through both personally and musically in the Adore period really created the like a garden by which we could grow. We could take what we did in the past but move it into a completely new direction where we wouldn't have been able to do that if we just tried to linearly start after Melancholy. So it literally took putting down and saying, I'm never even going to go back there.